Offensive line did a nice job allowing him to do that. I am surprised. I know West Virginia was averaging 43 points coming in today's game, but off the surprise.
That is the backup quarterback, Drake Jones. He transferred here from Miami. He is a backup with professional potential, and the way things are going, some of the scouts here this afternoon will get a chance to see that arm before this one's over.
That's just Vinny Testaverde at Miami. He transferred here over a year ago. Big time arm.
Gary Brown and O.J. McDuffie are back for Bowman kickoff. Brown lets it go out of bounds. It'll be a 5-yard penalty to West Virginia. So tomorrow, the NFL today at 12:30 Eastern. Come along with Dick Butkus, Irv Cross, and the tie. Brown at the 9, 15, 20, out to the 27-yard. Number 4 from Miami bringing him down. We should talk about the recruiting pace for this West Virginia team. Like a lot of schools, they go into New Jersey and Pennsylvania and Ohio for a lot of their linemen. But when they want running backs and wide receivers, they so many school athletes does Florida turn out every year. It is unbelievable. Sean Redmond and Gary Brown are into the backfield for Penn State. This is Brown. 35, 40, 47. A first down for the Nittany Lions. And Darrell Whitmore returns, bringing him down.
Still plenty of time for Penn State with 2:34 remaining in the half. They have 3 timeouts remaining to get on the board with another touchdown.
Throw it, as all day, Wait throws back in. incomplete. Keith Wynn is tied in, was the intended receiver, but Harris wisely got it out of bounds. Jim Manzanera will come along and they'll talk about the bowl invitation to limit. Yeah, which one can coach West Virginia to come?
Earl Farsiegan will give us any information about what Notre Dame is thinking.
He knows.
Will he tell us though?
I don't know. Come on, Earl. Step up to that. Bauman. Hammers it through. Another field goal. 24-yarder by Bauman. 34-8. A minute to go in the first half. The power is shifting in the East. A year ago, it was Syracuse exploding in Penn State's face. Now it's West Virginia. And at the conclusion of the CBS Sports College Football, don't forget the cadets of West Point.
You're absolutely right. I think they're 6-1 now. See them later in the year.
A great game in Philadelphia. Army, Navy. One we always look forward to. Bauman now. Throwing the ball down on the tee. McDuffie and Brown, the deep men for the Nittany line. Brown lets it bounce, fields it on the 1 yard line. In trouble. And down at the 16 yard line. Let's go downstairs to John Doctor.
They're wrapping Brian Chismar's knee behind me over here. The irony of it is, in the first quarter, he took off his knee brace because he was limited by it and he wasn't feeling good about it, so he took it off, and then what happened? Someone rolls over on his right knee, and right now you can see them wrapping it in ice. One of the game's ironies. Now back to you, Brent.
All right, John. And Sean Redmond, 22, is the fullback. Gary Brown, 27, back behind the Penn State offensive line. 54 seconds to go. For Tony Sacca, New Jersey. It's been a very rough education for Sacca. This is Brown, down at the 17-yard line. And Penn State, really not spot. West Virginia has two timeouts remaining.
And again, they run the no-huddle offense. They're going to have to throw the ball downfield and hope for a big play. Give Simpson a chance.
Drop it off for Brown and threw it out of bounds, stopping the clock with 31 seconds. One thing you do not want to do right here is stop that clock very often. You don't want to give the major a last second opportunity the way he can fire.
Beautiful place, this Morgantown. I've really enjoyed my week here. The people have been awfully nice to us. Great college town. Situation for any quarterback, but particularly for an 18-year-old freshman like Tony Sacca has been. At 2 weeks in a row, as West Virginia calls a timeout, they have one remaining. But a very...
Who knows what after that? Francis Bell.
And Darryl Whitmore, number 11, has blocked two punts this year. He'll be coming off the corner.
We'll be at the bottom of your screen. The short side, number 11, he'll be the wide man. Helps out through the punt. Gets it off. Fair catch. At the 45-yard line, 13 seconds for Major Harris. And the wide receiver. Nealon with some final words before he comes out.
And remember, West Virginia is not afraid, as we've seen in this first half, to throw the ball downfield. They figure they're going to throw the ball downfield 6 or 10 times a game. If they don't catch it, they're hoping for the pass interference.
Johnson explodes, 30. to attempt the extra point. Has that man ever been in the middle of a situation like this?
Paterno has devoured one and all. He has hammered Eastern competition, winning 110 of 121 games. The last year it was Syracuse, and now, Pat Hayden, West Virginia clearly number one in the East, at least until the Syracuse game. Why? What's happening?
It's wrong to call them a Cinderella team, so this team can play, but I think it's recruiting. And I really do believe that the schools, the Syracuse, the West Virginias, the Rutgers, are chipping away at the recruiting. And remember, those schools have some pretty good head coaches, Nealon, Dick Anderson at Rutgers, of course, and Dick McPherson at the Syracuse. So once they get those athletes there, they coach them pretty well.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if Rutgers isn't the next to emerge here in the East. These schools have been willing to step up and spend money on the facilities. That's been very big. We're going to come back with the second half right after this message. It's 41-8, West Virginia, and the Mountaineers will kick it off to start the second half against the Nittany Lions with Gary Brown and Leroy Thompson set deep to return it. Thompson, 15, 20, 25, down at the 28-yard line. Short time ago, John Dockery caught up with Coach Don Nealon as he came out of the Mountaineer locker room.
Coach, in your wildest dreams, did you ever imagine a half like this?
Not really, John, but I'm smart enough to know we got 41, they can get 41. They get 41, they beat us, so we're starting all over.
So he told them, it's nothing, nothing, and let's go from there. And the Mountaineer defense out on the field, and we'll track this one now carefully for you. Missouri upsetting Nebraska, second half, 15-14. Oklahoma fans interested in that one. On first down, tackle with time, gets away from Turnbull, scrambles, and steps out at the 40-yard line.
One of the biggest adjustments a high school quarterback has to make, and remember, Tony Sacco was playing as a senior in high school just a year ago, is to be able to find that second receiver, because in college football, the receivers get covered very, very quickly, and he's got to find a way to dump the ball off.
David Daniels and Simpson go wide to the left. They'll run right straight ahead with Brown. First down for Penn State. Darrell Whitmore
before bringing him down.
Penn State rushing yard, really tough to run against this West Virginia defense. But remember, they've had to throw the ball a lot because they've been behind so much, and that's what the freshman sack are facing. A big deficit is going to have to put the ball up, come up with some big play.
Daniels and Simpson again to the left. Brown and Redmond are the running backs. They move Young to tight end to the left. Brown again steps inside, tries to follow a block, and he is down at the line of scrimmage with Chris Herring in a bold knee, number 49 and 3 all over it.
We have been calling Chris Herring's number all afternoon. He has done a sensational job of not crossing his legs, coming down the line of the scrimmage. And watch Herring, he's right in here. See how he's feet in? Look at his eyes. Doesn't cross the legs. Comes right down the scrimmage, fights off a block, fights off two blocks, and then makes the tackle. Five tackles on the day for Herring.
Second and long. Couldn't hold it and went out of bounds with Whitmore, number 11, pushing him out of bounds here on the near side. That's the first half. 421 yards for the Mountaineers. 554 is the West Virginia record for a single game. Third down and 10 now. Participation call that we had in the first half. Did they have Bryant with those 12 defenders too?
Illegal participation, defense, 12 men on the field.
It's a very popular defense this afternoon in Morgantown. The old 12th man team.
I love it. And what West Virginia is doing is coming with inside pressure by the linebackers and flushing sack out, making him throw the ball on the run.
With the score 41-8, you really should be playing with 10. That's not fair. First and 10 now for Penn State. Ball is at the 45. Young over to the right side. Simpson and Daniels are the wide men for Saka. Saka rolls in that direction. Incomplete, and there's another penalty marker down at the 40.
I think once the tight end moves over an unbalanced line, as number 80, Todd Young, did, he's an ineligible receiver. And he released and went downfield.
That's the signal.
Penn State has come out in the second half and run a lot of unbalanced lines so far. They'll shift the tight end over. But once he does that, he cannot go downfield.
Second half, searching for a rhythm. Back-to-back penalties.
And now we'll be receiving offense. First down.
Ball is brought back to midfield. It's first and 15 for the Nittany Lions. 27 is Gary Brown. He's the tailback. That's Simpson coming into the squad on the right. They run and get to the 45-yard line with Thuron Ellis bringing him down, and Brown with a game that will leave them with second and long. Let's check in with Jim Nance in New York.
Well, Brent, fifth-ranked Nebraska has moved back in front of Missouri. Chris Drennan with a 29-yard field goal puts the Cornhuskers in front. 44 seconds left in the third quarter. Nebraska leads. Let's go back to Brent.
Now, a little order restored in that one, and here it's 41-8 West Virginia. This time, drops it off to Redmond, and the fullback is short of the first down. And Thuron Ellis, number 66, he has been all over the place.
And Ellis has done a great job of playing inside linebacker today, number 66. He moved from outside linebacker a year ago into the inside, and that's a tough adjustment. Doesn't sound like much, but you have to be much more physical. Things happen a lot quicker on the inside, and he's one of the few guys who's been able to make that adjustment without much problem.
Third and short. Put it up. Scrambling to the right. As time incomplete. A great defensive play by Willie Edwards, number 47. Hometown boy from Morgantown.
In very good coverage. The tough thing when a quarterback is scrambling is to be able to maintain the coverage, but Edwards, number 47, does a great job of knocking the ball away from David Jacobs.
Daniels couldn't hold on. Was it interference?
It looked like he may have gone through with the left hand before he knocked the ball out with his right.
Can't touch any part of that face mask, and it was close. Fourth and short. Penn State Turner will have to go, and Gassie's short. And actually, Saka did not give it to the fullback. He was touched down, and the hot blue is taken over on down.
This is what West Virginia did in the first half. Marvelous maintenance of their drive. You see the touchdown, too. They're not kicking many field goals, getting the ball into the end zone and going a long way to do so.
Marvelous maintenance. Is that, like, pretty darn good? Harris rolling to the right now, being chased, and he is down at the 29 as Quintus McDonald, number 92, calls him down.
Only the seventh sack of Major, who has really come on the last couple of weeks for Penn State. And today they're using him on both sides. Ordinarily, he lines up over the tight end, but he's playing some to the open side today and made a nice sack there.
He's the leading sacker on this Penn State team, senior from Montclair, New Jersey. Well, there is an inactive right leg. Lance Carrion hasn't had to punt yet today. Now they hand off, and Brown, what a play. 34-yard line, and D'Onofrio, number 38, bringing him down.
Carrion's worried about getting a letter. He may not get one.
Harris waits for the play, being delivered by number 15, Lamont, one of the wide receivers. Win the tight end. Brown is the tailback. Taylor is the fullback. Bell and Lamont are wide. Goes. He tried to backpedal, and he slipped and went down. The ball being spotted at the 26-yard line. This is the worst-looking drive so far, and Carrion on to the field for his first punt. Ten-man front for Penn State. Out of bounds near midfield. Good field position for Penn State. So when we come back, they'll have the ball at midfield after a 25-yard punt. Seventh game of the NBA Finals. The Phantom of the Opera. The Super Bowl all wrapped into one. A new stadium record. 3,500 standing room only. And on first down, Leroy Thompson, the ball carrier for the Nittany Lions. He makes his way near the 45-yard line. It'll be a second down for Penn State.
One of the players in on the tackle there was 47, Willie Edwards, and he's a guy I have some admiration for. One of those guys who has kept football in perspective, came here to get an education, will graduate in May with a degree in psychology.
Saka, over the middle, Pimpson, incomplete.
One of the things that Penn State is trying to do a little bit differently is throw some shorter routes to take some of the heat off of Saka, because he was under some duress in the first half. And receiver seeing you running shorter routes, he's trying to dump the ball. That time, he didn't have much success, though.
Third down for Saka and Penn State. Pinson comes out to the right, and Daniels to his left. ball was hit by Drumgoole, number 25.
He hurt himself going down, and they have two strong safeties hurt now. What's Drumgoole, who times his jump perfectly? This is an art in itself. The strong safety, again, sees that the ball is going to get over his head, but times it just right and makes a very athletic play, comes down funny on his left leg and grabs his left knee. It already hurt lost Bo Orlando.
Orlando, one of their senior leaders in that secondary. Drumgoole stepped in last week against Boston College and did a fine job. And while he's being tended to, let's check in with Jim Nance in New York.
Well, Brent, from 55 yards out, final play of the game. Texas going for the win against Texas Tech, but Wayne Clements misses the long-distance field goal, and Tech comes back from a 32-15 deficit to drop the Longhorns to 3-4 on the season. Let's go back to Morgantown.
Wild one in the southwest. Arkansas, still the class of that conference and headed toward the Cotton Bowl. Now Helkowski to punt. And they run the fake this time with Collins, the linebacker. And he gets a first down for Penn State.
Well, Brett, the amazing thing to me about that, West Virginia was expecting a fake. They were not in a rush defense. Look how many guys are back. But it was just well blocked and then run well by Andre Collins, a linebacker who is a converted strong safety, so he has some speed.
Bobby Bowden set that play up.
I'll always remember that play.
All of us will. We still haven't seen it. First and 10. Ball is at the 26-yard line. Cash and Thompson, the running back. Back of the freshman, behind the center. Thompson, here comes the Paterno with a little razzle-dazzle.
Oh, when you're going into a score, because the team has a tendency to overreact. They thought they could come up with a big play with Timpson, but the people on the backside stayed at home, and it didn't turn out to be a tremendously big play.
Braylon, 41-8. Paterno opening it up. Fake punt. In the round with his world-class speed. Gash and Thompson, still a running back. Back at his throwing. Going toward Timpson and over his head and out of bounds. He was covered by Mays.
And that's real good coverage by Alvord Mays, number 3. He felt the wide receiver was going to run the deep route and just ran right back with him and didn't get back any room to make the throw.
So Marshall, West Virginia, number 2 in Division 1 AA. They are unbeaten, following the leadership of the Mountaineers in this state. Over Appalachian State, 30-27. Now third down and short. Here's Thompson. Stacked up. No hole. Couldn't find his daylight. It'll be fourth down for the Nittany Lions. Trailing 41-8. They'll undoubtedly go for it in this situation.
One thing about this West Virginia defense, they can afford to take some chances, blitz people, play man-for-man defense, because their offense is so good and they put so many points on the board. A new philosophy for this defense. They'll really come after you with blitzes and man-for-man defense.
They have 2 yards to go against Neyland's defense. Coming up to hit him. And Ellis also in on the stop.
Nice block on the left side by Jonathan. Eric Jonathan, number 74, who really led the way for Thompson to pick up the first down.
First and 10 for Penn State inside the 15-yard line. Jacob is 86 to tight end. Fake to Thompson. Wants Timpson. Throws to him instantly, and Whitmore is there again. First-year player from Royal Virginia with great potential.
And again, he
does a real nice job of playing center field, reading the quarterback's eyes, and then reacted. He felt the receiver was open, waited to the last moment, and then made the burst to knock the ball away. That's a great play by Whitmore.
5'11", 178. Good size for the corner man, and that great speed that you look for. Second and 10 now for the Nittany Lions. This is Thompson to the 11-yard line with Pickett, number 45, hanging on.
Eight different players have carried the ball for Joe Paterno's Penn State team, including Wisniewski, an offensive guard, and a linebacker, Collins, and Simpson, a wide receiver. But still, they haven't been able to get the ball in the end zone much.
Redmond brings the play in. Daniel Van Smith comes to the right side. A slot to the right for Saka. Saka under pressure. Steps away. Now being pursued. Just does drop it off, and it is dropped by Brown inside the five. And Saka was close to going past the line of scrimmage. So here at Mountaineer Field in Morgantown, West Virginia. West Virginia leading Penn State 41-8. With 6:13 to go in the third quarter, and a penalty flag down, it's going to go against West Virginia.
And it's been a game very much a big play here as they call the defensive holding against West Virginia. They give Penn State a new lease on life. So far in this game, it has been West Virginia coming up with all the big plays on offense.
And that gives them a first down goal. Picks in the slot and with Daniels. Redmond in front of Thompson. Thompson to the three. Teron Ellis. Here was Thompson.
How about Franco Harris and DJ Dozier and John Cappelletti? They've had some good running backs.
There he comes, Brown. And he is hit down at the 2-yard line by Herring, number 49 from Pueblo, Colorado.
Brent, they may score here, but they need to score quicker to get back in the game. They've held the ball for over 4 minutes on this drive.
Chris Herring. The right personnel onto the field. Smith hurries on. Gash is the fullback. It'll be third and goal. Gash, touchdown. His second of the afternoon for Penn State. And for the season, number 6. Another 2-point conversion. For Penn State.
Last time they sent a man in motion, tried to hit him quickly.
Activity continues on that Penn State sideline. Gash, who had an injured ankle, just went off. And Redmond is back in at fullback. Simpson and Daniels are the wide men to the right. The move throws incomplete. Simpson did not hold it in the end zone.
Saka may have been able to run that one in, but here's the touchdown by Gash, number 11. Watch the center and the guard as they crosswalk, and another determined inside. gas playing on a very tender ankle.
So it's 41-14. 5 minutes left in the third. We'll be right back. Conversion did not work for Penn State. Great play again by linebacker Chris Herring, 49. Watch behind him. He steps in and applies pressure, and Sacker will throw it. Simpson at the other end probably should have caught it. It would have been a major league catch, but he had his hands on it.
Long scoring drive. Again, they're happy that they score, but they just took too much time when you're down 41-14.
With the only score of the second half, and Atkins can kick it off. Napoleon is number 33, back there at the four. Will they go for an onside this early? They take it deep. Napoleon at the 9-yard line, 20. And bolts to the 30-yard line. Downstairs to John Dockery. Doc, have you found John Denver yet?
Not yet, Frank, but I'm in the locker room, and it's on you, and he's a master motivator. All around the locker room, signs like this, concentrate, execute, and winning will take care of itself. Why? He's even gone so far as to enshrine the equipment from some of his former great players, like Darryl Talley, the linebacker, now with Buffalo and Central All-American. You know, I asked one of his players what they thought about this kind of motivation. They said, you know, Coach Nealon knows how to get our attention. How about you, Brent?
He is one of the best in the country. Surrounded by great football factories, if you will, he's done a job here. And Brown breaks free. Comes out to the 49-yard line. Chris Cesar finally got him out of bounds, a 16-yard run. How did Brown get free?
And it's staggering to me. He picked up a couple of nice blocks on the right side by Kovac and Snyder. But the staggering thing to me is that West Virginia over 12 yards on first down. That makes it a lot easier game, believe me.
First and 10 for Major Harris and the Mountaineers. Penn State's offense dominating the clock in the second half. Taylor, the fullback, battling out near field. There's a penalty flag down. Face mask calls going against the Nittany Lions. And Giannetti coming up defensively. The ball is put down at the Penn State 45-yard line. It'll be a first and 10 for the Mountaineers. Jamie Lamont brings the play into the Mountaineer huddle. Taylor and